Hey, thanks for stopping by, you tune sleuths. In this video, I want to explore the correlation between two songs that are separated by about 34 years or so. The first is the well-known Star Trek theme by Alexander Courage.
To boldly go where no man has gone before.
And the second is a song from 1931 or so, written by Johnny Green and Edward Hing, called Out of Nowhere.
You came to me from out of nowhere.
And just in my short study about it on the internet, there's an awful lot of discussion between these two songs. So that's what this video is. I want to look into this. And I got curious about it and thought, well, what the heck? What if I were to score out the melody lines for both tunes on the same sheet of paper? Well, I did. Here it is. Star Trek, Out of Nowhere. When you get right down there and look at it, there's some stunning similarities. Some anchoring points and some chord harmonizations that are identical, and it's really cool. All right, so let's start looking at some of the commonalities. Right off the bat, first thing is, of course, they're both in common time, 4/4 time signature. The key signature you see here, I've got them both in G major. That's just a convention. Because Out of Nowhere is written in G major, but the Star Trek theme actually is pitched in B flat major. But for the sake of discussion and to be able to put them side by side, I've lowered the key for Star Trek so that it too is in G major. Okay, so let's look at the form. Both tunes are exactly 32 bars. Now, the first 8 bars comprises section A. The second 8 bars comprises section B. The third 8 bars comprises a recap of section A. And then the final 8 bars is section C. That brings us to the conclusion. Well, in truth, there really are two separate Star Trek themes that play for every episode. They're different. The opening of the show always begins with that mysterious sort of woodwind part here. And then that French horn playing the Enterprise fanfare. All right. And then it goes up a major third. And then the trumpet carries on the Enterprise theme. How about up another major third? And then it gives us this incredibly altered dominant chord. I'm going to call that an F7 flat 5 flat 9, which pulls right into the theme song, and off we go. So that's the opening portion, whereas the closing theme is the entire form, starting from the first measure. Okay, is that clear? Good. Now, for our melody comparison, you really don't have to look very far to find a commonality. How about the downbeat of the first measure? Both tunes start on what is the fifth degree of the scale. In the key of G major, that would be a D. All right. And then they play the first little melodic tune over 2 bars. And then they both end on the same note, an F natural. All right. See that? So here's the start. Star Trek is this. To an F natural. Out of Nowhere is. There's that F natural again. All right. But it doesn't stop there. Let's go on to measure 5. Basically, it's a recap of that same melody, and yes, they both again start on the D, and they end on the same tone, only this time the ending tone is an F sharp, which is in the key signature. So Star Trek is this second phrase. There's that F sharp. And Out of Nowhere. So there it is, both ending on that that F sharp. The difference is that F natural in measure 3 seems to want to pull us back down to that reannouncement of the second running of the theme starting on the G major. Whereas ending in measure 7 on the F sharp seems to want to propel us forward into what's to come next. Okay, one more characteristic of these two melodies side by side. I want to point out this. At the very start, generally ascending, da, we're going up here. In the second measure, we're coming down, descending down to that F natural. Out of Nowhere does the same. Starts on the D, moves up to an A, and then generally winds up down the G, down there to the F natural. That carries over as well, of course, into the second phrase. We're going to go up the octave this time, and then work our way down to that F sharp. Likewise, Out of Nowhere is moving up and then trending back down to that F sharp. I thought that was a pretty key element to this. I want to go back to the very beginning of the piece once again, just to point something out here. So, all right, we talked about this. Both tunes start and end on the same tones over the first 8 bars. Now, also, both melodies have an ascending and a descending characteristic. Okay, so here is where I want to point out the secret sauce. This is the key ingredient that is in both sandwiches that make them both delicious. This third bar, this little chord right here. Notice it's the E flat 9 chord, and that occurs in both places. This is what's called a borrowed chord. There's no E flats or B flats in the key of G major, so we're borrowing from the G minor key signature, which is has 2 flats, B flat and E flat. And we're playing this. This is the lowered 6th chord with a 7 and a 9, and this is how it works. Here is Out of Nowhere. See that? Here's your E flat. This is the lowered 6. And we have B flat. Here's our 7, and here's our 9. Makes it nice and juicy and pulls it back into this. All right, Star Trek. Same chord. That's what everybody hears when they say there's a similarity between these two songs. It's that E flat 9 chord employed in that third bar. In the book, The Music of Star Trek, Alexander Courage told a great story about a friend of his from over at MGM. His nickname was Brawny. Brawny had coined a term, and he referred to shoulder chords. A shoulder chord is one of those that the snazzy jazzy lounge piano players kind of throw their shoulders into when they hit it, you know, like this. Oh yeah, there's lots of shoulder chords in the Star Trek theme. It's full of them. Mr. Courage never really indicated that he was aware of this chordal similarity. But somewhere along the line, somebody did know. In the first season of Next Generation, I believe it was episode 12, called The Big Goodbye, a great episode where they are in basically a film noir 1940s spy thriller. Let's check this video out. This is Out of Nowhere, suggested, by the way, by Robert Justman, the series producer. So obviously he knew back from the original Star Trek days that this song with this. Same similarity of sound.
I wish I could take you with me. Someone has to book this creep. Once a cop, always a cop, I guess. I have to go. So, this is the big goodbye. Tell me something, Dix. And you've gone. Will this world still exist? Will my wife and kids still be waiting for me at home?
I honestly don't know. Goodbye, my friend.
Well, I hope this was interesting to you. It sure has been interesting to me. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. Leave a comment if you got any questions about this. Maybe you know a better name for that chord than I came up with. Thanks for stopping by. We'll catch you next time, you tune sleuths. Tune sleuths.